light. Have you ever heard that expression? Well, it's at the heart of our Ask Me Anything Science Edition question today from Mara, grade 3 student in Fergus, Ontario.
Hi. The other day my mom asked me to move faster than the speed of light. Of course I asked, how fast does light go? Since my mom loves to do experiments, we decided to measure it ourselves.
That's right. And you can do this experiment at home in your own kitchen. All you need is a microwave, a ruler, and some chocolate chips.
Chocolate chips. Let's do it.
All right. So light is a wave, which means that if we know the frequency,
which is how quickly the waves move up and down, this is high frequency, this is low frequency.
That's right. And if we also know the wavelength,
which is the distance between peaks, this is short wavelength, this is long wavelength.
Right. And if we have those two numbers, frequency and wavelength, and we multiply them together, we get the speed of the wave.
Hold up just one second. What does that have to do with chocolate?
Good question. That's how we're going to measure the wavelength. We're going to take these chocolate chips, put them in our microwave, and melt them just for a few seconds until they just start to melt. When we do that and take them out, you'll see an interesting pattern, and that's going to tell us the wavelength of the microwave light.
Really? Let's do this! Tune the microwave!
Okay, so you see how we've got a pattern here. You've got stripes of where it's melted and where it's not melted happening on the plate. So can you measure how far apart those stripes are for me, please? What have you got?
About 6 centimeters.
Okay, so that's actually half the wavelength. So the full wavelength would be?
12 centimeters.
12 centimeters. Okay, so we need the frequency now, which we get from the microwave, either inside the door or on the back. Our microwave here is 2,450 megahertz, which is 2,450 with 6 zeros after it. So we take that really big number and we multiply by the wavelength, which is
12 centimeters.
12 centimeters in meters is 0.12. Together, that gives us a speed of 2.9 times 10 to the 8 meters per second, or about 300 million meters per second, which is what we expect to measure for the speed of light.
That's a fancy number. And crazy, crazy fast.
It is crazy fast. So at that speed, it takes only about 8 minutes for the light from the sun to reach us all the way here on planet Earth.
Holy Pluto! Which makes me wonder, what if we lived on Pluto?
Good question. So Pluto's a lot further away, which means it would take a lot longer for the light to reach us on Pluto. It would be, in fact, about 4 to 6 hours to reach us on Pluto.
Cool. So if we could turn the sun off, it would be 4 to 6 hours before anyone on Pluto noticed?
Yeah.
Is there anything faster than light?
Nope. So when I asked you to move faster than the speed of light the other day, I was actually asking you to do something physically impossible.
Hey, no fair!
I'm sorry, I was just trying to get you moving. Okay, one more thing. You know in a thunderstorm when we see the flash of lightning a little bit before we hear the thunder? Well, that's because light moves so fast. So as we know, it moves at 300 million meters per second. So we see the light almost instantaneously, but it takes sound longer to get to us. So if you time in seconds how long between the flash and the boom of thunder and divide that number by 3, you get the distance from you to the lightning in kilometers.
Cool. Thanks for doing an experiment with me.
It was my pleasure, and thanks for the great question. If you have a question for us, just let us know.
Thanks for watching Ask Me Anything.